Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
So it was a very pleasure to host you on the campus today, and the session was very interesting and very interactive. Thank you for the session, sir.
No problem.
So sir, my first question is, like, how was your interaction with the students of SIPM Pune, and in terms of LGBTQ awareness, how it was?
I think the session went really well. I was really pleasantly surprised with the questions, the caliber of questions, the depth of knowledge that students had. I didn't walk in with thinking like, you know, first there will be so many students, so almost 200 students were there. So I was very happy with, you know, not just number, but also the quality of discussions we had, and the openness and willingness all the students demonstrated. I think you guys definitely, all of you have a really bright future ahead of you.
Thank you, sir. So now, like, the inclusion for the LGBTQ community is opening up. So do you think that inclusion should be there right now, or it is time for the formulation of policies for discrimination against that on the basis of sexual orientation? That should too come on the forefront and be amalgamated.
Right. So I think it has to be, we can't wait for laws and policies and things to change and then do something about it. I think we have to make an every effort to kind of, you know, start having an inclusion as part of our everyday conversation, or, you know, within the private sector, if we can have policies that are inclusive, we should do that. We cannot just wait for the legalities to change and then, you know, do things. Because I think even if legalities will change, changing people's minds and hearts is going to take a lot of time. So we cannot wait to, you know, for the legal things to change and then do something about it. I think we all can start our own
change. You start a change right now.
Absolutely.
Okay, sir. So how challenging it becomes for managers and employers to hire and, you know, engage LGBTQ workers, and especially in a country like India, where it is built upon customs and religions. Mm-hmm. How difficult it becomes?
See, when I consider India in general, I think this topic is still new for India, LGBT, especially in the workplace. It is still a new phenomenon, and so, and even like a lot of LGBT individuals, it is hard for them, or it is challenging for them to come out or be open about who they are, because of Section 377, as well as because of, you know, the social and cultural boundaries that we have. So it is really, it's not that easy process. But I know a lot of companies, including Cummins, we are now starting to think about how can we, you know, think about this aspect of diversity. How can we partner with groups like, you know, or maybe there are on-campus groups for LGBT students. How can we partner with them? How can we let them know that Cummins is LGBT supportive? I think those are some of the efforts that, you know, companies are starting to do. But as I said, this is still a new territory for a lot of companies. But definitely, I think, you know, the talent is, because at the end of the day, it's the search for talent, right? Talent, right? And so talent is out there for within the LGBT community. So companies like Cummins definitely value that.
Yes, so you have been an inspiration for many people who are, you know, still skeptical about the idea of acceptance and, you know, inclusivity. So like now you coming out to the world, then you're getting married, and then beyond that your career and all. So what has been your source of inspiration and, you know, optimism which you have?
I think source of inspiration means, I think, well, you know, I went through a lot of my own struggles of accepting myself and, you know, just going through a lot of bullying and all those things. But I think that helped me become a stronger person. So I think once you go through a lot of those struggles and challenges, it actually gives you a lot of strength and a lot of that, you know, that grit and determination that, you know what, I'm not going to be this, you know, sad and unhappy and depressed person. I'm going to, you know, make the most out of what the opportunity I have. And that has been my own kind of, and you know, once you have that image, or once you kind of know that there is nothing wrong with you, and you have every right to succeed, and you have every right to live a life just like anyone else. That gives you confidence and that inspiration within yourself. So I guess, you know, that's, you know, I never thought about it, but I guess that's, you know, because I just kind of kept living life and experiencing life. And I think a lot of these individuals who bullied me or who, you know, made fun of me, that gave me a lot of strength, to be very honest. I didn't realize it at that point in time, but now when I look back, I think those experiences made me much more stronger.
Building the strength.
Absolutely.
That was a very inspiring answer. So, like 1992, like what I've read, 1992 was the first when the first protest for the gay rights happened. It has been 25 plus years since then, and people are still, you know, fighting for the basic rights for the LGBTQ community. So now, observing India, what do you think? How far has India progressed, and how much more distance has to go when it comes to the basic rights for the LGBTQ community?
See, in India, we have a very unique situation because we have this archaic law, Section 377. Which is actually not our law. Britishers got this law to India, and in their own country in 1975 they have got rid of this law. So, but we are still carrying that law with our this thing. So it's unfortunate that we have such laws, and those laws are actually a hindrance to a lot of people coming out, or, you know, their process of accepting themselves. So those laws are actually creating a lot of trouble for LGBT community. So I'm really hopeful that that law will change, because once that law changes, it will give a lot of validity to LGBT individuals for who they are. Because right now, a lot of these individuals don't have that courage, because their parents or society does say that, hey, what you are doing or what your sexual orientation is actually illegal. So in a way, it is actually not helping LGBT community. It is not helping their families. To accept their kids or to accept their relatives. So I think we need to change that law. It's an archaic law. It's a law which is actually having a lot of impact on basic human rights. I mean, you know, when you think about LGBT community, even if we take a conservative estimate, it is 3-5% of the total population. So for a country of 1.2 million, just imagine how many LGBT individuals we have within India. Mm-hmm. And with this law, we are saying that these individuals are illegal or their life is invalid. So in a way, we are creating a lot of disservice to this community by having that archaic law. So for me, I think once we change that law, things will progress. But changing people's hearts and minds is going to take time, because we have all these years of you know, stereotyping and fear of unknown that is still out there. So that will still take some time to change those things.
That stigma will take some
time. Absolutely.
So, what advice or what motivation you want to give to the people out there who are still struggling with the idea of sexuality and who look out in others for support, or look for someone who can support them? Mm-hmm. What advice will you give them?
I think my only advice will be, you know, be who you are. You know, there's nothing wrong with who you are. If you are part of LGBTQ community, I think, you know, there are a lot of resources now at your disposal that you can use. Be confident. You know, there are a lot of happy, successful people, you know, LGBT individuals, who have accomplished a lot of great things in life. So my advice will be, you know, just focus on those things. Focus on some foundational career. I think once you have that strong foundation, strong financial security, you get a lot of confidence. You don't then, you know, care for, not you don't care for, but you, you know, people's opinion don't matter. If you don't have that financial security, then it becomes very hard. So I would say get, you know, financial security, be independent, be on your own, you know, and be happy. I think LGBT individuals go through a lot of, you know, depression, a lot of mental health challenges, and you know, unnecessarily. I mean, it's because of society's attitude towards them. So I would say don't fall into that trap. I think the world is out there to embrace you, but you have to, LGBT individuals have to take that first step of coming out and accepting themselves. So that would be my advice to them.
Self-acceptance.
Absolutely.
It was a wonderful conversation with you. Like, I'm honored to have the conversation.
No problem, it's my pleasure as well.